Hello everybody, E here. Welcome back to another book review. Today we're talking about yet another Off Limits Press book, and that is In Nightmares We're Alone by Greg Sisko. I was very standoffish about this book. I have a irrational fear of dolls stemming from and spiders, both stemming from my childhood. So I try to stay away from anything baby doll related because they freak me out. Of course, this cover does not help much. There's even more disturbing stuff on the back. Yeah, I'm trying not to look at it. But yeah, the very first story, well, it's not really a story. This is a kind of a mosaic novel. I guess it is a mosaic novel. You have three interlocking novellas, and each one of them has a different horror element. One is about a baby doll. One is about things growing out of someone. And the last one is about ghosts and some cosmic horror stuff thrown in. I will go ahead right now and tell you I'm a huge, huge fan of this book. The very first story messed me up to the point where I had to stop reading. This is, of course, the one about the doll. I had to stop reading for, I think, 2 weeks to clear my head once I was done with it. And I stepped away from it, and I came back to it, and I'm so glad that I did, because I had no idea that the rest of the book had nothing to do with, you know, the doll. So that was really, really good that I pressed forward. I'm going to put this down. So the next story, Growth, the first one is, what is the first one called? The first one's called Good Little Dolly. The second one's called Growth. The second novella, but all these stories, they have the same characters, just not the same main characters. The first one is about a little girl named Macy. The next one's about a dude named Casey, who's a medium. He's a fraud, but he's a medium. And the last one is, I can't remember the lady's name right now, but I remember her husband's name. His name is Arthur. Maybe it'll come to me when I get into the review some more. But with Growth, as soon as I finished Growth, well, first off, I highlighted numerous sections of this. There are so many simple truths in the second story in Growth about growth. About, you know, changing and redemption, and, you know, maybe not redemption, and just realizing, you know, you're a horrible person, or realizing some truth about you and hopefully growing past that. But also, it's about this dude who has vegetation growing out of him. And that's not a spoiler. That's, you know, on the back of the book. There's so much about this second one that I want to talk about, but I don't want to spoil it for anybody. But I highlighted numerous passages. It is a very deep story. It's deceptively deep. Sisko's writing is amazing. It flows perfectly. The editing is on point. Everything about that side of things is great. The creeping dread throughout the whole thing, because you know it's not going to end well. you know, growing branches from your fingertips. I mean, how can that end well? There's a little bit of a surreality? No. There's a surreal aspect to it that I really enjoyed. Same with the first one. You're always questioning whether or not these things are actually happening. And in the story, even the characters question whether or not these things are happening. But it's not so vague and obtuse that you don't find out whether or not these things are actually happening. Okay, you get your answers. As soon as I finished the second story, I was like, this is easily a contender in the top five books of this year. Off Limits Press has gone above and beyond the Call of Duty with their stuff. They only pick the most amazing content, and I'm really, really impressed. And the only reason why I didn't fanboy over the last one I read, with Heart Strange and... it's Tim McGregor's book that the review's up on the channel, is because I wasn't a huge fan of, like, the the setting. I don't like too much historical fiction, not, at least not that around that time frame in that era. But this one is right back to the five stars. It's like Hailee Piper's The Worm and His Kings and Laurel Hightower's Crossroads. So we're back up to five stars again. And that the only reason the last one was four is because it's nitpicking. Anyways, what I'm saying is I'm impressed with their output. Insanely impressed. The last story in here is a little more basic than the first two, but no less deep. I really, really enjoyed seeing that each and every story has a very unique character point of view. It's all they're all written in first-person perspective from the characters whose head you're in. The first one is from Macy's point of view. She's a little girl. Sounds like a little girl. Acts like a little girl. Has little girl thoughts. Amazing. Second one, Casey is a douchebag. He's conning people because he's a medium. You tell him he can speak to the dead, so on and so forth. And then in the last, and he's a douchebag in his head, too. You know, the way he thinks about women, the way he treats women, so on and so forth. And then you have the final story. I wish I could remember this lady's name. It's going to bug the absolute dog mess out of me. So, yeah. Since it's written in first person, there's no telling what the actual, anyway. But, and because it's first person, you don't hear the names much. But it's Arthur's wife. I hate that I can't remember her name. I apologize. It's not that she's a bad character, because I really enjoyed watching Sisko go from little girl to douchebag to nihilistic older woman in her 50s. The range that this dude has is insane. Every single character felt unique. Every single character had their own not their own plot. Of course, they had their own plot, but every single character felt like they had a purpose. That's very important to me. Even side characters like Martin, the little boy, that was some character. And the way each and every story ties into the next story was amazing also. If you guys can hear those birds, I apologize. I can do absolutely nothing about nature, but, they are distracting me. I want to call this a novel. I'm not going to call it a collection, a novella collection, because everything intertwines. I was impressed by the way they intertwined. But I think the biggest thing, other than just saying the characters, the pacing, and the dread all on point, that's stuff that I look for in every horror novel. Amazing book. But the writing here, Sisko has chops, man. Like, I was in awe reading this. The way he turns a phrase, especially in the second one, I love it when an author can give me a terrible character that I enjoy reading. Like Joe Goldberg in the You series, or Caroline Kepnes' You series. And the second story, Casey was that kind of character. And it was, I could just sit here all day talking about how amazing this is. I want you to go out and read this for yourself. I don't want to say any more about this. So go out and check this out. It's from Off Limits Press. Buy it from their store. I'm going to link down there in the doobly-doo to the Amazon affiliate link. That helps out the channel if you buy there. But I would much rather you go and pick it up from, like, Off Limits Press, their website. So I'm going to link to that down there along with the Amazon link, because I know some of you, you just want quick and fast. I get it. But if you can, help out a publisher that is doing things amazingly, amazingly well. But have you read In Nightmares We're Alone by Greg Sisko? If you have, let me know what you thought of it down there in the doobly-doo, whether or not you loved it, whether or not you hated it. If you loved it or hated it, tell me why you loved it or hated it so that we can have a discussion. But until next time, I have been E, you have been you. This has been another book review. I'll talk to you guys later. Bye-bye.